हेलो फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड्स, टुडे यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम एंड एक्सक्रीटरी सिस्टम ऑफ इंडियन कैटलीज, दैट इज यूरिनेरिया ग्रैनुलोसा। सो हियर यू विल स्टडी डिटेल्स अबाउट दीज टू सिस्टम्स। सो डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ यूरिनेरिया, दैट इज इंडियन कैटलीज, वेरी you know characteristic, and it is divided into alimentary canal and digestive glands. And if you talk about alimentary canal, then the alimentary canal is a straight tube, and it is greatly modified due to its sanguivorous habit, that is blood sucking habit. It is further divided into three main parts. First is stomodium, also known as foregut, and foregut includes mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx. Second part is mesodium or midgut, or also known as mesenteron. It includes esophagus, crop, stomach, intestine. Third part of alimentary canal is proctodium, or also known as hindgut. It includes a single part, that is rectum. So foregut, you know, it is it consists of mouth, which is a triradiate structure present at the base of cup like depression. It's known as preoral chamber. The roof of this chamber is membranous, and it is known as velum. Mouth consists of three flaps which form three lips of the mouth. Second part of the stomodium is buccal cavity, that is mouth opens in a buccal cavity which is lined by cuticle. It contains three crescentic jaws, one mid dorsal in position and other two ventrolateral in position. The free margin of the jaws is provided with a single row of teeth or denticles, that is, this condition is known as monostichodon. So here you can see that these are the teeth or denticle. In the diagram you can see very well. So this condition is known as monostichodon, that is, teeth are present on one side of this tooth. So that we can say these are the salivary papillae. So one side these teeth are present on the jaws. So there are 103 to 128 teeth on median jaw and 86 to 115 on lateral jaw. Each lateral jaw carries 42 to 45 button-shaped salivary papillae, which possess openings of salivary glands, and jaw make, they make Y-shaped wound on the body of victim. Third part of stomodium is pharynx, which is a very high muscular suctorial oval sac, and it is found in 5 to 6 segment, and it is surrounded by unicellular pyriform salivary glands. The saliva of hirudinaria, it contain an anticoagulant, and it is known as hirudin or anticoagulin. This hirudin prevents coagulation of blood while feeding. Many radial and circular muscles connect the wall of pharynx with the body wall. So here in the second diagram you can see, this is prostomium, this is preoral chamber, this is median jaw, these are the lateral jaw, and you know, this is body wall, this is buccal cavity, and it leads into pharynx, then esophagus, then crop. And these muscles are present, which are radial muscles or dilators of pharynx. These are very characteristic, which produce suckling effect or sucking action of the pharynx. Now, second part of the alimentary canal, that is midgut. Midgut includes esophagus, which is a short and narrow tube, opens into crop. Crop is very important, and this is the largest part of the alimentary canal. It is found one in each segment from segment number 9 to 18, and it is divided into series of 10 chambers. That is, crop is made up of total 10 chambers. Each chamber consists of a small anterior part and a broad posterior part having lateral backwardly directed blind outgrowth known as ceca or diverticula. Here you can see these are the lateral cecum. In this diagram, these are the chamber, crop chambers. So these are the crop chamber, these are the lateral ceca. So there are 10, total 10 chambers. 10th chamber is the biggest one and its ceca extend as two greatly elongated blind sac. This is the 10th chamber. Its ceca are very, you know, these are very long. And crop chambers are highly elastic. They can store blood several times more than their original size, which may last for more than 6 months or even a year. Next part of alimentary canal, that is stomodium. It is a funnel-shaped tube. And the last crop chamber leads in through a sphinctered aperture into stomach. It is present in 19th segment and contain both secretory and absorptive epithelial cells. Next part of mesodium is intestine, which is a narrow tube present in 20th segment to 22 segment. Its internal lining has a spiral villi-like processes to increase the surface of absorption. Now, third part of alimentary canal is hindgut. It includes rectum, which is a somewhat dilated thin wall tube extending from 22nd segment to 26th segment. And anus is present on 26th segment. Now, food and feeding mechanism. As you know, that hirudinaria is sanguivorous habit and it sucks the blood of cattle and other domestic animals. When leech comes in contact with any animal, then it fixes its posterior sucker. You know, it fixes its posterior sucker and then applies anterior sucker to its body. By the contraction of muscles, the jaws protrudes out through mouth and moves like saws, and they make the characteristic triradiate or capital Y-shaped painless incision in the host skin, and the oozing blood is sucked up by the suctorial pharynx. The suction force is created by the contraction of radial muscles present around the pharynx. Now blood is passed into crop where it is stored. Digestion of the food. The sucked blood is stored uncoagulated in the crop chambers where it is hemolyzed. The hemoglobin from ruptured RBCs is separated and get dissolved in plasma due to absorption of water from blood plasma by crop wall. The blood become thicker and darker. Blood from crop passes drop by drop through the sphinctered aperture into stomach, where it changes into green in color due to hydrolysis of hemoglobin. Absorption of digested blood occurs in the intestine. The digestion is brought about by gut bacteria. Complete digestion absorption of full meal may take about a year or more. Undigested food is stored temporarily in rectum and egestion takes place through the anus. This is all about digestive system of hirudinaria. Now, next system of hirudinaria is excretory system, and it consists of 17 pairs of segmental nephridia. You know, their number is 17 pairs, which remain present in 6th to 22nd segment ventral to alimentary canal, one either sides of the ventral nerve cord. These are absent in first 5 segments, that is 1 to 5, and last 4 segments. So it is divided into two types. Number one is testicular type, that is testicular nephridia, which are 11 pairs present in 12 to 22nd segment. Second is pre-testicular nephridia. These are 6 pairs present in 6 to 11 pairs, 11th segment. And testis sac, perinephrostomal ampulla and ciliated organs are absent. This is the difference between these two types. So, we will study the structure of testicular nephridium. So, these are 11 pairs as you I have told you. Remaining 6 pairs are pre-testicular. So, you know, these are testicular nephridium. These are 11 pairs from present from 12 segment to 22 segments. And these are known as testicular due to presence of a pair of testis sac. These are horseshoe shaped nephridium. And, you know, it consists of six parts. So, first part is ciliated organ. It occurs inside perinephrostomial ampulla, suspended from the inner wall of ampulli by 4 to 5 strands or trabeculi. It corresponds to the funnel or nephrostome of a typical annelid nephridium. And ciliated organ consists of a spongy central reservoir and ciliated funnels, and they manufacture the coelomic capsules. In embryo, it has a distinct cellular connection with the nephridium, but in adult, it loses the connection as well as excretory function and becomes a part of hemocoelomic system for which it manufactures coelomic capsules. Second part is main lobe. It forms horseshoe shape. You know, it is a horseshoe proper. It is the largest part found in a ventrolateral position. And you know, it consists of two unequal limbs. This is the main lobe. Here you can see in the diagram, this is you know, main lobe, and it has two unequal limbs, a long anterior limb and a short posterior limb. Anterior limb, you know, it forms vesicular duct, whereas posterior end buzzes forward to form apical lobe. Now, third part is vesicle and vesicle duct. Duct arises from the inner ventral end of the anterior limb or main limb. It runs posteriorly to open into a large bladder or terminal vesicle. Now, vesicle is a large oval sac with non-contractile thin wall internally lined by a ciliated epithelium. So, here this is the diagram of testicular nephridium. So here you can see, here this is initial lobe, and this is apical lobe, this is inner lobe, this one, and this is main lobe. This is horseshoe shaped structure, and you know, here this is a central canal running into it, and finally it forms a vesicle duct. It forms further a bladder and it forms a nephridiopore. So, vesicle is a large oval sac with non-contractile thin wall internally lined by a ciliated epithelium. A short and narrow excretory duct lined by a non-ciliated epithelium leads from vesicle to open to the outside through the nephridiopore. Cilia are in fact non-motile bacteria, the nephridial microflora. Next part of nephridium is apical lobe. It is quite large, formed by inner free end of the posterior limb of main lobe. Its anterior end is slightly swollen and bent on itself like the handle of a walking stick. Next part is inner lobe or incurrent lobe. It extends between the anterior lobe and posterior limbs of main lobe. It also, you know, run forward along the outer side of apical lobe for about half of its length. Next part is initial lobe or testicular lobe. It is very long, narrow, transparent cord-like structure. And you know, apical lobe closely coiled around the initial lobe. This initial lobe, you know, coiled around the apical lobe. Its posterior end joins the main lobe, where as anterior end runs inward and reaches over the testis sac of its own side, where it ends blindly close to the perinephrostomial ampulla. Now, what is the physiology of excretion? Urinaria is ammonotelic in nature, that is excrete ammonia, and it performs two functions. First is excretion, second is osmoregulation. The nephridium releases the, you know, ammonia from the hemocoelomic fluid continuously flowing in the capillary network of nephridium. The fluid containing ammonia travels to the vesicle, from where it is expelled out through the nephridiopore. According to few scientists of workers, botrytal tissue also have excretory function, which have in communication with the hemocoelomic fluid. So here you can see, this is the direction of the fluid circulation. that is the anterior part of the apical lobe, then it enters in the posterior part of the apical lobe, then crosses over into inner lobe, then whole length of inner lobe, loops in the apical lobe, reaches in the posterior end of the apical lobe, then reaches in the posterior limb of main lobe, then finally anterior limb of the main lobe, and finally in the vesical duct, then in the stored in the vesicle, and it passes out through the nephridiopore. This is all about for the excretory system. So like, share and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get my videos. Thank you very much.